Today, I'm gonna take a failed Nuzlocke from one of my subscribers and see if I can save it. What's going on, everyone? My name is Patterson. Welcome to something a little bit different. I have taken a failed Nuzlocke game from one of my subscribers, and today we're gonna see if we can salvage it. The email that they sent me says the following. I've got a Nuzlocke save file that I didn't manage to beat for you. Here's my run of Callum's Vault White Egglock with Luke, so bear in mind the nicknames aren't mine. I managed to get up to the Elite Four, but I can't beat them all in one go. I'd love to see you have a go. Okay, so basically what is happening here, someone has sent me a failed Nuzlocke, and I'm gonna see if I can get past the point that they were stuck on. So it's my goal here today to beat the Elite Four with as few deaths as possible to see if I can get them in a position where they can finish the rest of the game and hopefully not lose. Let's have a look at the team to see what they're rocking out with. This isn't my save, this is their save. Like I said, they have Lord Bacon. We have an Ember here, which is actually a fire ground type because we're playing Vault White, which is a difficulty increased version of Pokemon White. It's called a Draenor hack because it was made by Draenor, and it's really, really hard. It's totally different to your normal game. So here we have Lord Bacon, who is fire ground type, okay. We have Draxia, which is jolly natured, which is really bad for a Glaceon. That's not ideal at all. It does have Serene Grace, which is nice, and it's holding Wise Glasses to boost that special attack, but has a minus special attack nature, which is not so great for a Draenor hack. We have a Sableye on our team, which is interesting to see, actually. We got Foul Play on there. That could come in handy. We got Goblin the Crobat. Interesting. Okay, it's jolly natured. Nice. We got a little bit of leftovers on there. Kind of bulky. We got ourselves a huge power Azumarill with Life Orb. That's going to be doing so much damage. And we have ourselves a Machamp as well. So, not a bad squad. I'm actually going to take a quick look into the PC to see if there's anything else I could potentially use here. We have Vibin. Okay, there's nothing else of level here, unfortunately. We do have Heaven. Oh, we have a death box. Oh, this is a sad looking death box. Oh, this makes me sad. Jesus Christ. All right, well, that's the death box right there. I'm just gonna make sure really quickly that we are stocked up on Hyper Potions and Full Restores. Yep, we have 50. Let's go for a couple more Max Potions then. No reason not to get absolutely everything that we can. And let's quickly check the bag. What do we have here? Oh, a Bright Powder. Now, I actually think that maybe the Bright Powder could come in more handy than the Focus Sash. I don't see the Focus Sash being a huge, huge thing here. I'm going to put the Bright Powder on instead. And I do have a Choice Band that I could add to... thinking here. We have an Experience Share. We have an Expert Belt. We have more King's Rock. More Leftovers, too. I might want to change up some of these items at some point. Even a Rocky Helmet, which the Rocky Helmet could come in handy a little bit later on. I have to remember that Azumarill is not a fairy type in this game. Now, I think the biggest thing I'm scared of is going to be the fighting type Elite Four member, but we're going to give it our best shot. We're going to go in here and we're going to try. Now, I will leave the link for my email in the description. If you guys want to send me a failed Nuzlocke save, reminder that you can't really still send randomized games because I won't have, you know, your randomized game. Mainly things like Draenor hacks, ROM hacks, and normal games and normal saves would work best with this if you do want to send one in. I don't know if I'll do any more of this in the future. It depends on how you guys react to this video. Anyway, let's do the ghost type team Elite Four member first. I'll put Kieran in the front with the Bright Powder. I can't really think of maybe Macron just to get some big damage. Now, the problem is these are double battles, which is a big issue. These are double battles, and it's gonna be... I'm kind of scared about that, to be honest. I could go with the Shadow Ball. We do have that. And of course, Lord Bacon is right here. Lord Bacon has a King's Rock, and I don't know why it has a King's Rock, considering it's too slow to really take advantage of that. So what I'm gonna do, I'm actually gonna change that King's Rock out, and instead, I'm gonna give it a Choice Band instead. And I think that this could be a decent... it could be decent, but we will see. I mean, I might want to lead with this, actually. Because a banded Flare Blitz, I mean, we do have also Earthquake, so I could go Goblin and Ember instead. All right, we're going to start off with this, and we will see how it goes. So she's leading off here with a Drifblim and a Golurk, which is less than ideal for my boy Ember. In fact, that's really bad for Ember. Don't want to lose someone right off the bat to probably an Earthquake, if anything, actually. So, what do we do here? Do you think it's worth it to double into the Golurk right off the bat? I don't know if I'll outspeed it, though. Now, technically, Ember does have a higher base speed than Golurk, so I probably could outspeed it, but I don't know if it's worth it. I think what might be a better idea is to immediately swap into my Machamp here and kind of hope for the best. All right, we're going to swap into the Machamp. We're going to see what happens. Goblin goes up into the sky. Good. Shadow Ball, a miss, and Earthquake. Okay, all right, that's not a bad start there. That could be worse. That did a decent amount of damage. And Flare Boost comes out with Drifblim. Now, issue here is I'm a little bit worried about getting immediately dunked on by a double with the earthquake and the flare boost with Shadow Ball. So that's a bit of an issue. I do have 127 speeds, so I might be able to outspeed the Golurk, but I don't think I'll be able to kill it right away. I actually just think I'm gonna max potion my Machamp this turn because I really don't want it to die immediately. We come in with a fly, which is nice damage. We'll see if the AI knows that I'm gonna come down here. Drift Boom goes for Hurricane! Okay, that's a dead Machamp. That's definitely a dead Machamp, right? You're not gonna be able to live that one, I don't think, buddy. We live, though! And Golurk uses Earthquake, so unfortunately we do die with Machamp immediately. Jesus! Okay, that was not a hot start. Not a hot start at all. We've lost Machamp. Now, the goal here is to not lose anyone, so not great. Definitely could be doing a little bit better here. Now, I think the Drifblim is a little bit more of an issue. I'm actually going to double into the Drifblim this turn because I think that we can kill it, and then all I'll have to worry about is getting Earthquakes. That doesn't do very much damage at all. No flinch, but it does miss. Nice. An Earthquake comes out. Hopefully, it'll miss with the Bright Powder. Bright Powder not coming in handy here. But we do take that very nicely. Shadow Claw is probably going to kill that Drifblim, though. Yeah, and Drifblim does go down. Does it have Aftermath? No, it has Flare Boost. Okay. So, like I said, losing Machamp, really not ideal, but we can live and learn. Frostlass comes in next. Earthquake and Ice Beam is a scary combination, but I think that Drax can probably come in here and take that. And while Drax is taking that, we might have an opportunity to just knock out this Golurk right now. So I'm going to kill the Golurk if I can. We'll see what happens. I feel like Frostlass is definitely going to Ice Beam into the Crobat slot. It's got it, right? Goes through a Blizzard, and it lands on both? What is this Sprite Powder even for, man? What is this Sprite Powder even for? Okay. Unfortunately, Golurk is gonna go for Shadow Punch into Drax. Okay, that was a lucky turn right there. I'm not gonna lie. That was a pretty lucky turn. We go for the Shadow Claw. Don't know if that's gonna knock it out though. It is gonna kill it. Alright. A little bit of a scary situation for sure, but we might be able to rely on a little bit of hacks here. That's kind of what I'm hoping, because we don't have much of a shot outside of that. I am gonna double heal this turn. So I want to make sure that we're not losing anyone. Okay, Shadow Ball comes out into Sableye. Not great. We don't have the best special defense. And Hydro Pump as well goes into Drax. No misses, unfortunately. Yeah, that's not ideal. In fact, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go into Macron here instead of Drax. I'm going to stay in with my Sableye because I want to try and bait it into missing. As much as possible, I would love to bait it into missing. I want you to take advantage of that Bright Powder. Land both Blizzards again. Must be nice. Must be so, so, so nice. And it does so much damage to Sableye. Can you miss, please? Can you miss? Can you miss? Can you miss? No misses. Okay. No misses, unfortunate, but we're alive. Now, the question is, do I even try and go in the offensive here? I don't know. We do have a waterfall that we could use. I still kind of want to bait them into missing something, so I am going to max potion here. I don't think that they will. Frostlass is going to Shadow Ball into Azumarill for sure. Yep, there it goes. Frostlass Shadow Balls into Azumarill. They're probably going to double into Azumarill. Can we miss a Hydro Pump? We can't miss a Hydro Pump, and it goes into Sableye. Even though we have the Bright Powder, it's doing nothing for us right now. Swapping may have been a bad choice, but at least at this point, I could probably Waterfall into Frostlass while keeping my Sableye alive by healing it, hopefully. Thunderbolt! You had that the entire time? What? Oh, that's not good. Come on, we live it, though. We take that. Okay, as long as we don't get hit by the Jellicent here. I think the Jellicent should hopefully go into my Sableye. I'm really hoping that's gonna happen. Frostlass immediately dies. We just don't wanna lose Macron too early on here. Will-O-Wisp comes out. Still doesn't miss, but I mean, we can kinda take that. Chandelure is gonna come out, and I know that Chandelure already has it's got a Grass-type move. I know 110% this thing has a Grass-type move. But I think what I wanna do here is I can Aqua Jet into Chandelure and use your turn to full restore Macron. So I get fully healed up here. And I think a huge power stab boosted, super effective, life orb boosted Aqua Jet might actually be able to kill it. At least that's what I'm hoping for anyway. Not enough to kill. Okay, that's bad. Yeah, and out comes Energy Ball.
Okay. Oh, don't do it.
Okay, that's really bad. I was hoping that would be enough to kill. Maybe you have enough health points to live. We live though. We do live it. Hydro Bomb comes out. Still lands. Not a single miss yet, by the way. Okay, like I said, not ideal. but I have a plan for this turn. I don't think that Macron can go down here, and I think that Jellicent is still kind of focusing down the Sableye. So what we're gonna do is I could double heal. I don't think it's worth it. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna full restore into Kieran this turn, and I'm just gonna have to, wait. I'm gonna Aqua Jet. We're gonna Aqua Jet into Shandy, and then we're gonna full restore Kieran this turn. Oh, wait a minute, the heal though, I totally forgot that they can heal. What an idiot. Okay, so that's not gonna do enough damage, unfortunately. We get a Will-O-Wisp coming out here into, it's gonna be the Azumarill, unfortunately. Okay, so now we're burned. This doesn't leave us in too bad of a position though, actually. I mean, as ironic as that sounds, I'm not too bad of a position here. Cause I can Aqua Jet into Chandelure this turn while also full restoring into my Azumarill. So there goes Shandy. Shandy goes down. So we're actually sitting pretty nice here. Hydro Pump comes out again. Still no misses. And ooh, almost a crit. I thought that was gonna be a crit. It wasn't a crit though. I'm glad that it wasn't a crit. Miss Magius could be an issue. So I'm gonna Waterfall into it. I'm just gonna continue to heal my Sableye because eventually you're gonna miss. T-Bolt comes out into Miss Magius. Yeah, I kind of thought it would have something like that. That's an issue. That's going to do a lot of damage. Going to do a lot of damage. But Waterfall coming out here is going to do insane damage. Because this thing is not going to live it. There's no way. And that Miss Magius immediately goes down. Okay, good. Okay. All right. Nice. We get a nice little beautiful level up. Will-O-Wisp again. And now you only have one Mon. Oh, okay. Now I feel a little bit more confident. I'm going to use Macron's turn to heal Macron. And I'm just gonna quickly, I could Shadow Claw, I could Foul Play. I guess I'll Foul Play into a Jellicent. I'm just gonna heal. I just wanna make sure that we're all safe and happy. My special defense does go down, which is obviously not great. And now I can use this opportunity to maybe go into Goblin here, who is a little bit more bulky. I can get rid of this burn, which I will do, absolutely. And now we can proceed to hopefully win this turn. Just kidding, I got burned again. Can you miss one move, please? Are you kidding me with this? Just one, dude. Just one move. Oh, and that's disabled too, great. Okay, let me foul play instead. Sand Headbutt, maybe get a flinch. We didn't get a flinch. But anyway, we did, okay. First Elite Four member is done. Jesus. That was rough. All right, I'm actually going after Marshall next because he's the one that I'm most worried about here. I feel like Marshall's going to be the biggest issue for us because I really don't have anything for it. I have a bunch of weaknesses to it. I have a Crobat that's going to get stone-edged into the next millennium. I have a Glaceon that's just going to immediately die. Like, I have a lot of weaknesses to this man's team. So really, I just kind of have to hope that I get lucky. And that's really most of what my plan is here. Sok is going to immediately close combat me, which is terrifying because that's going to do so much damage. That did a lot of damage there. That's a lot. That's a lot right there. Okay, but Waterfall into Zen Headbutt should be able to knock it out, I'm hoping. It has Sturdy, but it should go. It's still going to go down this turn. And it also has a Salac Berry. Superpower comes out. Hopefully not enough to... Please don't be enough to knock me out. Please don't be enough to knock me out. Please don't be enough to knock me out. Oh, we barely live that. And its attack and defense has lowered, which is huge. We're gonna have to use... Why do you miss? Okay, so this is the worst possible situation that we could be in right now. Basically, what just happened there is while I have the Bright Powder, I managed to go ahead and All right, that's great. I'm really glad that this happened. All right, so basically my plan here is to just let that throw get weaker and weaker and just leave that Sok there. Well, I'll try and kill the Sok actually. Hope that it doesn't crit me and we'll just see what happens because I don't think he has another full restore, so I should be able to knock out the Sok this turn. So let me just do that. And then I think I need to keep my Azumarill like as healthy as humanly possible. He withdraws. I should Aqua Jet. I shouldn't have Aqua Jetted. Let's go, Miss Click King. That worked out in my favor. All right, well, we take those, dude. We take those. Superpower comes out, that's fine. The more you use that, the better I feel. Because having a useless member on one side of the field that's just sitting there doing no damage and just like slowly murdering itself is absolutely fantastic news, in my personal opinion. Okay, this goes down to very low health. We'd like to see it. And also when Salt comes back in, I can easily just Aqua Jet it and knock it out. So that shouldn't be too much of an issue. I am just gonna double into Poliwrath this turn, I think. That's probably like the way to go with this. Let me see, let's go for the Brick Break into Poliwrath here. He's gonna Waterfall me. He's gonna Waterfall my Azumarill for some odd reason. I really don't know why he did that. That's very weird, but okay. We do live and Throw goes for a superpower again, which is again, totally fine. I'm totally A-okay with that. But if he crits me, the thing is, if he crits me, it's gonna bypass all of his attack drops because that's what critical hits do. And it's gonna be an issue. But I believe that we can do this. So Poliwrath goes down, Very good. Me and Xiao coming in next. Now, me and Xiao is a little bit of an issue. I am gonna, I could Aqua Jet it. I don't think it's worth Aqua Jetting. In fact, actually, you know what I should do is I should just Waterfall it. Because I think a Stab Waterfall would probably do more damage than the Zen Headbutt. So let me do that. We're gonna Stab Waterfall into me and Xiao and hope for the best here. What's it gonna do? It's gonna Stone Edge me. It could crit me here. It could have missed also, but it could crit me here. Okay, it didn't crit me. A Stab Huge Power Life Orb boosted Waterfall might actually be able to just straight up kill this thing. Yeah, nice! And throw continues to be useless, which you absolutely love to see. We have our Azumarill getting a level up there. Ooh, it threw its Flame Orb! Wow. That's actually big brain. Okay, that's kind of hilarious. It threw its Flame Orb. I wonder if he's gonna try and heal up his throw now. I'm not too concerned about this, to be honest. I'm just gonna make sure that I use these turns to keep my boys healthy. I'm just gonna Aqua Jet into the Sock because I don't want this thing on the field anymore. And I can immediately just kill that. So that isn't even an issue anymore. Sock goes down. And we still have that throw that is just like minus 70 million attack now. Oh, but it does have Facade. But it is minus attack. Yeah, it's doing like nothing. This is pretty much the best case scenario that we could be in here. But Conkeldurr comes in. Big boy. And big boy is a big boy problem. I do wish I had Will-O-Wisp on my Sableye now. I'm not gonna lie. We're gonna have to kill this thing relatively quickly. But I'm not gonna be able to do that while I'm kind of struggling a little bit. So what I'm going to do is we'll full restore into Kieran and we'll use the waterfall on Conkeldurr. I am a little bit worried about this. I'm not going to lie. He's going for Mach Punch, which is, you know, of all things, going to do the least amount of damage, which is okay. We'll see how much a waterfall does here. Huge power waterfall does so much damage. I love it. You love to see it. And throw just continues to sit there being absolutely useless. All right. One more turn. We're going to heal up Azumarill. And then we're gonna Aqua Jet into Conkeldurr. There we go. Nice. And down it goes. All right, I think we got it. I was really worried about this one because we really didn't have much of fighting types, but I think we have just nailed this. Yep, that's gonna be it. Oh, wait. Oh, it's not over. Wait, it's not over. You had a Breloom this whole time? How did you have a Breloom this whole time and you never used it? What are you, insane? I mean, I can just go into Goblin now. Surely, I can just go into Goblin and this shouldn't be too much of an issue. Mach Punch, okay. Rock Slide comes out, okay. That's doing enough damage, that's nice. And you shouldn't be able to outspeed me. And now I should just be able to clean your clock. Hopefully with a poison jab and a little bit of a cross poison. That should kill. Yep, and it does. Nice. All right, so there we go. Elite Four member number 2 is defeated. I really should have sold more items to get more full restores. That's what I should have done. Okay, all right. No, it's fine. All right, now we're going up against Mrs. Psychic-type user. And the thing that I'm most worried about here is Crobat's going to get absolutely mollywopped. But the thing is, Embor in this game actually is a ground type and not a fighting type. So that's going to work to my advantage today. And we have a Sigalith right there, but I have a plan for Sigalith. I have a plan for Sigalith, and Sableye is actually really going to come in handy in this battle. I'm just going to double. I think that one strength should knock out the Sigalith, so we don't have to worry about that. So I'm just going to try and focus down the Masharna as well at the same time. We're going to, because this is a banded strength. Okay, we immediately avoid the Hurricane, which is huge. Thank you so much. Getting a little bit lucky there, but we love to see it. Sigalith immediately dies to a huge, or not even a huge power, a choice banded strength in this game, which is rock type, by the way, in Volt White. If you don't know rock type, it's strength is rock type in this game. That's doing a huge amount of damage. And you're setting up screens. I'm gonna go for physical moves and we can't let this thing set up a reflex. That is 110% a thing that we cannot let happen. Under no circumstances do we let this thing set up reflect. So I think that I actually double into, well, I mean, there's no way I'm gonna miss. I can't miss strength. So I strengthen the Masharna to knock it out, and then we go for the Shadow Claw into the Reuniclus, because I simply cannot let that happen. So Masharna is going to immediately die here, which is fantastic. Reuniclus is going to take a ton of damage, which is also really nice to see, because Reuniclus can sit here and just set up and absolutely destroy me. If you guys don't know, a little bit of a throwback to my Draft League days, I have never beaten a Reuniclus, ever. I have never beaten a Reuniclus. If a Reuniclus is on someone's team, I lose to them every single time, without fail. So that's a little bit of a fun little piece of information for you. But it did set up a Trick Room, which is a little bit concerning because now it's gonna outspeed me. In fact, that's very concerning. And I really don't have much to hurt Bronzong with because I'm choice banded into strength. So it might actually be a good idea to Shadow Claw into the Reuniclus here and then switch into maybe Azumarill. I think that might be the play here. So I don't think that Reuniclus can do too much damage to me as of right now. And I should be able to kill it this turn too with no Reflect. Okay, Reuniclus goes for the Psychic, but that, as base, that's not gonna do a huge amount unless it's probably Life Orbed. Oh, Jarrabul comes out. That does nothing. Oh, you love to see it, man. You absolutely love to see it. Reuniclus does die. Yes,
finally!
Getting revenge against Uniclus. I'm so happy. Now we see Behem on the field. Bronzong just wasted a turn with rest, you absolute idiot. You fool! Behem immediately dies to a crit. It's all coming up Calvin here. Oh, I'm so happy. Okay, and that waterfall has done ridiculous amounts of damage, which is huge. Now, I could just use an Aqua Jet to immediately kill Bronzong to make sure that it can't do anything else, which I think I'm gonna do. We're gonna use this turn to heal up our Azumarill, and then we're gonna use this turn to immediately just destroy Bronzong. We're healing up. I thought that was her healing up. That's not her healing up. Okay, this should kill. And Bronzong goes down. Nice. We are just destroying things left and right here. Absolutely fantastic. Focus Blast does come out. I'm surprised that landed, to be honest. But that shouldn't do a huge amount of damage. I'm surprised this didn't go for Psychic. And it's down to her last mon already. I didn't even realize. So I'm actually going to try and conserve some PP here by just using moves that won't use up a lot of PP. I don't know if I need to. Oh, wait a minute, Thunderbolt. You had Thunderbolt, why did you go for Focus Blast? Oh no, that's bad. Is my Life Orb gonna kill? I don't think my Life Orb is gonna kill me. That would have been really bad though. That definitely, yeah, that was disgustingly close. I kind of hate that. The Twisted Dimensions have returned to normal. Gothitelle in this game is actually a ghost in dark type, if you guys didn't know, by the way. So we're gonna take an opportunity here to heal up Macron, and then we're gonna make sure that you can't. Wait, am I gonna outspeed you now? Twisted Dimensions return to normal? I think an Aqua Jet should be able to knock you out, so we're gonna make sure that we can kill you and not have to worry about anything here. Right? And you go down? Yes! Gothitelle goes down! Elite Four member number 3 is done! Okay, all that's left is the Dark-type member. I do want to say, Sableye has done a fantastic job here. I think this is time to kind of put Sableye in the back for a second, though, because we have the Dark-type Elite Four member here, and maybe Goblin plus Bacon could be a good way to start this. I could go for the Choice Banded Earthquakes, which would be really nice. I mean, he might have Honchcrow, he might have a lot of things, actually, that could be a little bit of an issue, but no, I do think that this might be a decent way to start. All right, Grimsley time, and he starts off with a water type, because of course he does. Why wouldn't he? All right, that does present a bit of an issue, because I am quite weak to water type on my Lord Bacon, which is not ideal. Not ideal at all. I can X Scissor into it, though, and immediately try and knock it out. I guess the best thing to do would just be to go immediately into Azumarill to take a hit, and then X Scissor with Goblin. Hopefully, that's going to be enough to knock it out. I don't know. Sharpedo's a glass cannon. It might just kill. Is it Focus Sash? Oh, it has Rocky Helmet? And Life Orb has Wild Charge? Since when? Oh, this is a rocky start. Sharpedo's going for Hydro Pump, though. I don't remember Sharpedo ever having good special attack, but we do barely hang on there. Okay, and Sharpedo is immediately getting a speed boost. Now, Sharpedo's gonna get healed this turn. And I think really the bigger issue for me to worry about here is the Lipod. So I'm gonna X Scissor into Lipod, hopefully killing that. And we're gonna full restore our Crobat here. Okay, so the X Scissor did knock out the Lipod, which is fantastic. Sharpedo does just kind of sit there. It is gonna get a speed boost, but I'm not too concerned about that right now. I'm more concerned about the Bishop that could Swords Dance in my face. I'd rather avoid that if possible. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna double into Bishop right now to make sure that it does not set up. Because if it sets up, it's just bad news bears. Actually, I could Brick Break. Actually, hold on, better plan. New plan. We X-Scissor into Sharpedo and we Brick Break into Bishop because that will 100% knock it out. Okay, you're gonna protect? Maybe I shouldn't have done that. I don't think it matters. Stone Edge comes out. Okay, we should have enough health to tank this unless it gets the critical hit. It doesn't get the critical hit. Bishop, go away. I don't want you in a house. I don't want you with a mouse. Okay, Bishop is done. Nice. Fantastic. Sharpedo just continues to sit there with Hydro Pump and Reflect being completely pretty much useless. And then Absol comes out. And again, I can just kind of heal my Crobat and use Brick Break into Absol. Because I don't think that... I mean, Absol could use like Thunderbolt or something. I think it learns a few... It learns Fire Blast for some reason. Really weird. Sharpedo is protecting again. We do have Mega Horn, which really shouldn't do too much. Doesn't do that much. And then Brick Break is going to annihilate this thing. And now we see Honchcrow. I knew you'd have Honchcrow somewhere. I knew you'd have it hiding somewhere. But again, I have a solution for this. I have Ice Punch. So why don't I just use Ice Punch to knock it out? Easy, right? Sharpedo uses Hydro Pump. That's going to do a decent amount of damage. Brave Bird comes out, though. I don't know if we live this. I think this might actually knock us out here. Oh, Crobat, you beast. Yes. And then we just need this Ice Punch to do enough to knock out the Honchcrow. It's gone. Yes! Fantastic! Okay, brilliant. Our record right now, we only lost Machamp so far. So our record is holding strong. Houndoom is... Okay, that Intimidate is really going to come into play here. So I'd love to Wolf all this thing, but I don't know if it's going to knock it out. And I feel like Houndoom might get some kind of Grass-type move. I feel like I need to stay in here, though. I don't think that switching out would be a good thing to do. We're gonna waterfall anyway, and we're gonna see what happens. A Hydro Pump missing would be nice. Okay, Aqua Jet comes out. That's gonna do probably more than the Hydro Pumps would do. I'm not gonna lie. Didn't. And it doesn't do that much. And do we get flinched though? Oh no, he doubles into the Crobat there. Okay, but Waterfall's gonna come out. I did get a negative attack, which is less than ideal, but I am huge power, and I am Life Orb boosted, and super effective, and stab. It didn't get... Wait, you Focus Sash? Oh, it has a Focus Sash, that's why. Now, I don't remember if he's already used his Full Restore. I think he has already used his Full Restore. All right, now we go on the offensive. We X-Scissor into Sharpedo, and we Aqua Jet into Houndoom. Sharpedo protects. That's totally fine. That is, in fact, that's absolutely ideal. So that guarantees the victory, because next turn, what we can do is we can X-Scissor and we can Aqua Jet. And that pretty much guarantees a dub right there. At least it should. I hope so. An Aqua Jet into an X-Scissor, and it shouldn't even be able to hit me now. Because I should outspeed it. Yep, that's going to do enough damage. Come on, that's got to be enough damage, man. He misses! Wait, oh, he outspeeds me because of speed boost. I totally forgot about speed boost. And it goes down! Nice! All right, the Elite Four has been defeated. Now, I'm going to leave it here because this is where they failed on. They failed on the Elite Four. So I want to see, I'm going to send this save back to them now. And I want to see, hopefully, maybe if they send me a message or an email, if they can actually finish this off. Like I said, if you have any Nuzlocke that you failed at any point during it, with your teams against maybe a gym leader, against an Elite Four member, against a rival battle, that you'd want to send me, if you'd like to see more of this, then please like it, like the video, leave a comment, and in the description, I'll leave the email address. If you have any failed Nuzlocke on Draenor hacks, if you have any failed Nuzlocke on ROM hacks, or on maybe a normal game, you can send me the save file. What you can do is if you're playing on an emulator, you can go to File, and then Export Save. Now, once you make a save, you go to File, Export, Save. That's how you export your save, and then you can send it to me. Don't send ROMs, though. I don't think you're allowed to send ROMs over email. I don't think that's a good idea, and I'm not going to encourage that. So don't send ROMs. You can just send save files so that I can take a look at them and maybe, you know, potentially get a big dub. But I hope you did like this video. It was definitely an interesting one. I am going to make a save right now. As it is, we only lost one mon, so I would say that's pretty much a victory right there. I hope you did enjoy this video. Something a little bit different, something I had a cool idea for that I thought would be cool, you know, a saving your Nuzlocke video. See if I could do any better. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. Like I said, make sure to send me your saves if you want to. And also make sure to follow me on TikTok and Instagram, because I post on that every day, and I stream every day on twitch.tv/pirates at 11 AM EST. People are like, I don't know you streamed. I'm just finding your stream for the first time. When do you stream? I stream 11 AM EST, twitch.tv/pirates, pretty much every day. All right, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Bye. Thank you so much to our Twitch subs and YouTube members of the day. Remember, if you are a YouTube member or a Twitch subscriber, that both gives you access to the sub Discord. And I appreciate you supporting the channel. Thank you so much, guys.